guys, welcome back to part two of the How We Get Fit series. The next couple of episodes, I want to go ahead and talk about recovery and why it's so important to help us make sure that we actually elevate our fitness after experiencing fatigue. So quick, a first recap of what we talked about last time. Last time we covered the stimulus fatigue recovery adaptation theory, which is basically the theory that explains how our bodies improve their fitness, okay? Just a recap of what that was exactly, we have our current baseline fitness represented by this horizontal line on our graph. We start here at baseline after our first training session, assuming it's intense, we're gonna actually see some accumulated fatigue. So our level of physical preparedness is actually going to decrease, okay? Now, once we allow our body to recover, we're actually going to see something called supercompensation, which is where our body starts to improve its fitness, okay? That's where you see, while we recover, we're actually going to increase our fitness above and beyond baseline, all right? And that's after we recover, like I said, okay? What I wanna talk about today is really about the timing of this supercompensation and when that happens, okay? And as we're gonna see, it coordinates along with the period of recovery that you allow for yourself, all right? And really when that is comes down to what type of training program you're following, all right? So let's say you follow a very a light schedule of strength and conditioning. So maybe you train twice a week and allow for 3 days in between your training sessions. We'll assume that you train with moderate to high intensity and that you do full body functional exercises on both days, okay? So if that's the case, what I wanna do is we're gonna go ahead and take away this for now. And we're gonna look at a 7 day week. So we've got Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Let's say we train on Monday, and then again on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, let's say Thursday, okay? And we get the weekend off. So now this would be a good routine for somebody that is in season. Maybe they're in season during a specific sport, whether that be a recreational sport or a high school sport. It's good for somebody who is inexperienced in training and doesn't necessarily have a large volume of work or hasn't been doing a whole lot of strength training, okay? Then 2 days a week might be plenty for them to experience that intensity and they might need that additional time to recover. Either way, with a schedule like this, we're probably gonna be fully recovered in between training sessions, okay? Large muscle groups take about 48 to 72 hours to fully recover as the research has shown, okay? Smaller muscle groups can take less time than that. And obviously there's some variance in there depending on how difficult our training is. The more difficult our training is, the longer the duration our difficult training is, the longer it takes to recover. But generally 48 to 72 hours is a good benchmark, okay? So we're training here on day one. So initially, like we talked about last time, fitness decreases, but we're gonna see it increase back above beyond baseline here on day four. We've allowed 72 hours to recover in between our training sessions, okay? Now that we've allowed that training to, or those training benefits to manifest themselves, because we've recovered in between our first two sessions, or in between our sessions, now we can go ahead and train again on day four it is now, okay? Again, we're gonna fall back below that baseline, but then towards the end of the week before our next training session on Monday, we're back up and elevated. This is Monday of the following week over here. So in that, we can see how recovering in between sessions allows us to get that super compensatory effect and increase our fitness, all right? Now, what I wanna do is talk about the difference between this and more of a intensively scheduled strength and conditioning program. So maybe we're training 4 to 5 days a week, okay? So now we're looking at CrossFit, we might be looking at bodybuilding, we might be looking at weightlifting or powerlifting, a lot of more sports-specific programs that require a lot of skills to be developed as well. Okay, so with those, we are going to train multiple days a week, all right? One key thing to note about this first program, like we talked about, we're allowing for that full recovery in between sessions. But what that means is that because we accumulate less overall fatigue before we allow supercompensation to take effect, that improvement in fitness, the improvements in fitness are going to be marginal, all right? So as we're gonna find out with this next program, your improvement in fitness is directly correlated to how much fatigue you accumulate over time, okay? So now, we'll take this away. Let's talk about that program where you're training 5 days a week, all right? our baseline level of fitness back. So now we're gonna train. We won't train Thursday, because nobody wants to train on Thursday. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, Saturday. Those are our training days. We're off Thursday and Sunday, okay? Now, this doesn't necessarily mean that we're training with intensity on each of those days. It likely means that we have a couple of high intensity days, a couple of moderate intensity days, probably a light intensity day, all right? You'd be hard pressed to find somebody that can truly train with true high intensity 5 days a week. All right, that's definitely not sustainable. If somebody tells you they are training with high intensity 5 days a week, in all likelihood, they're not actually giving a high intensity effort all 5 days. Okay, might be perceived high intensity, but it's unlikely that that's optimal performance for them. Anyway, rough aside there. So what we're gonna actually see is across these first 3 days, these training sessions are grouped so closely together, there's no way we're training, we're recovering fully in between those sessions. So here's actually what our strength curve is gonna look like here. So again, first session, down, slight recovery between, session two, down again, slight recovery between, down again. Okay, so now our baseline of fitness has really decreased through these first 5 days, and that's because we haven't allowed our body to recover, so we've really accumulated quite a bit of fatigue here across a week, all right? So now, let's say we've had this hard week of training, okay, and we're gonna go ahead and allow ourselves to recover the following week, all right? Before we had that situation where we were allowing ourselves to recover each and every day. So now, what we're gonna see here is because we've allowed ourselves to accumulate more fatigue over a given amount of time, now if we allow ourselves to recover, if I extend this out another week, all right, we're gonna start to see that our body actually elevates far beyond baseline, okay? So before we talked about those marginal increases in fitness when we allow ourselves to recover on a day-to-day basis, we're gonna get a much larger increase in fitness because we've allowed fatigue to accumulate. All right. So now this is the way most training programs, if you've been a college athlete or a high school athlete, they break down into mesocycles, which are basically 4 week cycles where we have, or maybe 3 week cycles, where you have 2 to 3 weeks of high intensity training where the volume or the amount of work that you're going to be doing increases over the first 3 weeks. And then we allow for recovery in that third or fourth week. So the last week is a recovery week. That's where this takes effect, okay? And the key point I want to make here is that you absolutely need this period of recovery in order to actually see supercompensation, all right? So, key things I want to point out here today, just to highlight, okay? You can see, regardless of how frequently you train, as long as you're recovering and you're training with intensity, you're going to see this supercompensation, this elevated fitness following that hard training, okay? That elevation in fitness is directly related to how much fatigue you've accumulated, okay? So if I allow my fatigue to accumulate, like we talked about in this second program, I'm gonna see a greater increase in fitness after the fact, okay? Now, what we're gonna talk about next time is what happens if we do not allow for this period of recovery, okay? So just a little science note here. What we're doing here, where we're actually letting our fitness decrease in order to allow ourselves to get this really great increase in fitness at the end of the cycle, that is called functional overreaching. Okay, and it's kind of intuitive what that means. Overreaching means you're basically sustaining intensity beyond which you can continue to perform at an optimal level. So you're going to continue to see that performance decrease over as long as you are training to that extent, okay, with that frequency and at that intensity, all right? That's functional overreaching. What we're going to talk about next time is non-functional overreaching. Non-functional overreaching is basically where the wheels come off, we train with intensity for too long, okay? We're going to talk about what that might look like and if that might be something that you're experiencing right now, all right? Thanks for tuning in, guys. Hope you got something out of this episode, and we'll talk soon.